Winter solstice. Yule. For this year's winter solstice, or Yule practice, we're going to do a restorative sequence. After we finish our practice, I hope you'll grab a pen and paper and make a list of things that no longer serve you, that you resolve to release today on the solstice. And then find a safe way to burn the piece of paper. I use a fire bucket in my backyard. Be sure you can burn it safely or don't burn it. But write down the things you don't need in your life anymore, the boundaries, and put them outside your boundaries, and then burn them up. I hope you'll have a nice Yule feast this year. It's a day when you really do need to eat and celebrate the return of the light. The shortest day is upon us. And each day we'll be getting just a little more light for just a little bit longer, which heralds the return of spring and the new growing season. If you have more than you need, share with those who are less fortunate. The blessings you share with others will return to you at least tenfold. Let's get started. I'm Carmen Cooper, by the way. You can find me at carmencooperyoga.com. We're gonna start off in a supported child's pose. I'm using a bolster. If you don't have a bolster, you can roll up a yoga mat and wrap it in a blanket or use pillows. Be sure that you're comfortable because we're going to hang out in these poses for a while. It's restorative. I'm going to stack my hands and prop my head on my hands. The pose of a child is one of the most relaxing restorative poses in all of yoga. And if you make it a supported pose of a child, it's even more relaxing and restorative. Release yourself, relax. Let this relaxing, restorative energy fertilize the seeds of the new things you want to grow in your life. I'm going to stop talking so we can enjoy quiet and relaxation and restoration. ease out of your pose of a child. We're going to switch to a supported, wide-legged forward fold. You can use your bolster. I'm going to prop mine up a little bit more even. I'm going to put a yoga block under it. If you need support underneath your knees, you can use a small bolster or a rolled up blanket or towel. Again, I'm going to prop my head up on my one hand stacked on top of the other. Be sure you're comfortable because again, we're going to be here for a while. We're letting ourselves go completely. Turning inward as a celebration of the solstice, celebrating the darkness before the return of the light. ease yourself out. I'm going to take the block out from under my bolster. And now I'm going to move into a passive supported back bend. I'm going to put my bolster under my shoulder blades and I'm going to lie back. If you prefer to extend your legs, extend your legs. If you want your legs folded in, or if you want your feet flat on the floor, whatever is most comfortable for you. Feel the opening of your heart as you hold this. If you need to come out before I do, feel free to do so. That's true for this pose or any pose that you do with me. If you ever need to release at any time, please do. Our bodies are not the same. We all have our genetic and injury history, and we have to practice within the parameters. slowly and gently roll to one side as you push yourself back up to sitting. Now let's go to a very easy legs up the wall. Move these props out of my way. I'm not going to get real close to the wall tonight. I'm going to have an angle because this is a restorative legs up the wall. Let yourself go. If your feet become tingly or excessively cold, feel free to release legs up the wall. That's your body's way of telling you it's had enough. Again, anytime you're practicing with me, feel free to release any pose we're working on at the exact moment your body tells you that it's time. bring your feet down. We're going to finish with a savasana, like it says on my shirt, savasana. If you need something under your head or something underneath your neck, if you want an eye pillow, feel free to use it. If you want a blanket, go ahead and get a blanket and cover up. I'm very hot natured, so I seldom need a blanket. Lie down flat on your back, palms turned up, your hands a short distance from your body, your arms outstretched, your feet 12 to 18 inches apart. Let your feet flop open. Go ahead and roll your feet in and out a few times and feel the smooth glide of the bones in your hip joints. Then feel your weight against the support of the floor. Allow your body to be heavy. Feel your weight sink into the floor. Relax the back of your head, the back of your neck, the back of your shoulders, the back of your arms, the back of your hands. Relax the spinal column. Relax the muscles of the back of your waist, your hips, your thighs, knees, calves, ankles, feet, and toes. Let go of all technique. Let your body breathe the way it wants to breathe. Inhaling and exhaling through your nose. I'm going to stop talking so that I won't distract you from turning your energy inward. Let's take a few moments and hang out with our inner space. slowly begin to move your arms, your legs. Turn your head from side to side as you gradually begin to roll over onto one side. Stay here for another half a minute. Let's don't be in a big rush to return to our daily responsibilities. And let's gently and slowly come back to sitting. I've recharged my batteries and I hope you have too. And I now have the resolve to plant the seeds that'll bear fruit for me coming next year. Scroll up. Keep it with you. Namaste. Happy Yule.